Even my dog is pitching in. Good boy, Ralphie. That's right where it goes. Good job. Yeah. So, here's my other dog. Addie's down there cleaning the weeds. This is day three of working on the grounds. We started Thursday. Jim and I came out Thursday evening, cleared the section with the driveway here from the street to here. So all the stuff that you see from left to right that's cleared and all the way out to the street, Jim and I did that Thursday and Friday morning. We spent the night out here. And then we went home Friday night, or Friday afternoon we went home. Now it's Saturday afternoon. We got out here a couple hours ago with my wife and I and the dogs. And turns out the brush cutter head that I bought is not adaptable to my weed eater, Troy-Bilt gas weed eater. So I'm gonna have to take them both back to Lowe's and find one that will be adaptable to it. And explain to them that when I bought them, they told me, because I told them I need one that will work for sure, with no doubt in their mind. And they told me beyond a shadow of a doubt that that brush cutter would work absolutely on that weed eater. So it doesn't. So I'm going to take them both back, and they're either going to give me a brush cutter head that does work on it, or we'll return them both and get the Cub Cadet version that comes with a brush cutter and weed eater combo in the same package, so we know they work together. We'll do that tomorrow morning, on Sunday morning. We gotta stop at Sam's Club anyway to pick up some steaks and other groceries. Yeah, I'm a big steak eater, so. But anyways, right now we're working on clearing the section. Addie's got her limb trimmer cutter things. They look like a giant pair of fingernail cutters. So she's using those to cut down the big limbs that the weed eater won't cut. And I've been using the chainsaw, chopping logs over here. Took down a couple of little trees, and then I started on these big logs. This tree here was already dead and down on the ground. It's been probably laying here for at least a year from the looks of it. And so I'm chopping it into logs. Got this one here, that one there, there. So I'll finish chopping. It goes all the way over to those big clump of trees over there. I'll finish chopping that up. And then there's another big tree right there that's laying down. I'm gonna chop that up. What I wanna do is get all these dead down trees. You got your log again? Yes, you're showing your log that you helped with. Yes, this is my dog, Ralphie. And he's helping carrying the logs back and forth, or at least this one log anyway. Yes, Ralphie, we know. What do you want to do with it? He's got such a strong mouth. Big heavy piece of hardwood right there. I don't know what kind it is, but it is very heavy and very hard. So he's got a really strong mouth. I hate to be on the end of, I'd hate to be the bad guy that he decides to chomp down on one day. So anyways, we're piling up the wood here that we intend to hopefully have seasoned in time for winter. Oh, you're gonna bury it? That's what it is. Hey, Addy? Addy? He's burying his log. Is that how you season your wood, Rafi? You bury it?
Oh god, it knows it's gonna be dirty again.
At least I got it on camera this time.
That's a beautiful thing.
That's a good spot to bury it, Rafi. That's your log, just for you. We'll use it to heat your doghouse. How's that?
Seasoning it, Rafi?
Yeah. Can you untangle them? So, anyways, this is where we're piling our wood for our first burn in our house. And I'll take those logs up today and we'll pile them up here too. And we've decided that we are going to clean out this section right here. And this is where I'm going to park my RV. Right here, I'll pull in, drive in right through here, pull in right here so my door is facing that way, park my RV right here, and then all I gotta do is just come right through here and drive right out that way, because that's gonna be cleared out anyway for the driveway. So my truck should fit between those two trees with no trouble, as long as I'm careful and slow. The RV will park down this way. It's pretty much level from left to right, but front to back is on a slope. So all I gotta do is, when I park it here, the tongue will be on this end. Put the two jack stands down on the lowest setting. And then on the back end, we'll set it up on bricks. And then that'll level the RV out. And then, cause basically we're gonna end up signing the contract next week, it looks like, so that we can actually move onto the property. So we're hoping that in the next few days, we will have this area here cleared out. It's tomorrow we'll get that done if it's not raining. It rained all morning today. And so we lost a half a day's work today. So, but anyways, so the plan is to get this all cleared out right here. And then as soon as this is cleared out, we're going to bring in the RV and park the RV here. We will pull water from the spring for our water, and we will filter it using our Sawyer water filtration systems for now, because the Berkey, we want to set the Berkey up inside the cabin. And I don't want to have to set it up and then take it down and then reset it up again. So we're going to use the Sawyer filtration system, and we'll show you how we're going to do that. We're going to strap the 5-gallon bucket up to probably one of these two trees right here behind me, right there. So it's up above the RV. We will have a military 5-gallon water can. We'll fill from the spring down there. We'll bring it over. We pour it into the bucket that's strapped to the tree. It gravity feeds through my Sawyer filter system into the RV's inside water storage tank. And then that feeds the everything inside the RV. The RV will dump into a Blue Boy black water tank. And the RV park has agreed to let us dump the tank as often as we need to, free of charge. So that's how we will take care of our waste water, gray water and black water and stuff, until we have our other system set up. And we have a 15 or 20 gallon Blue Boy portable tank, wastewater tank, that attaches to our RV. So that will last us approximately 2 weeks. So if we go and empty it once a week or once every other week, we'll be good. And since we can do it free of charge, we can do it as often as we want. So that's no problem. And why don't we just move straight into the cabin? That's because it takes 3 to 4 weeks before the cabin to arrive. And we've decided that we can get the RV down here, stay in the RV, and filter our water. Now that we have 400 amp hours on our batteries, that's more than enough power than what we need, because we're only running DC lights and our computers and our internet. That's in our small refrigerator. So 400 amp hours is way more than enough for what we, for the electricity that we need. And our solar panels are more than enough to charge those batteries. And our generator is more than enough to charge those batteries in the event that we don't have any sun. And my generator runs on, I think, a half gallon of gas for 8 hours, I think is what it said, or something. It was either a half gallon or 1 gallon. I think it's a half gallon of gas for 8 hours, something like that. But anyways, it won't take 8 hours to charge to charge my 400 amp hours worth of batteries. It'll only take about an hour or so. So running off the generator, that is. So we'll use the generator and the solar panels to run the RV. We will use the spring water to give us water. We'll use the Blue Boy for our wastewater while we're here. And that's just temporary system until the cabin arrives. We have propane that we'll use for cooking, and we'll also campfire cook. And that will last for about a month and a half until the cabin arrives. That way we can live here on the property while we do the work. We don't have to travel back and forth, so we'll save a lot of gas money that way. We will save, right now we're paying $300 a month at the RV park, so we'll be saving the $300 a month from there. And we'll also be able to set up my military canvas wall tents, also AKA yurts. And I get my yurt set up, and we can start pulling stuff out of storage unit and put it in the yurt. And I have a couple other tents we can set up too. So we'll get that stuff done. Let's see, anything else? You have anything you want to add, Addy? She's over there gobbling up my dinner mints. Huh?
We should bring more snacks.
More snacks?
No, I'm just kidding. There's plenty of blackberries.
There's spam in the truck.
Spam isn't edible until you've been on the trail 3 days and you fry it.
Uh-huh. So.
Sort of desperation.
We did decided that since I have a lot of friends like Troy and Kaz, Freedom for Kaz, I should say Troy is TechMan 2015. And then I have Freedom for Kaz, and I have Medic Jimmer. All of them have RVs. Freedom for Kaz, I gave him a pop-up trailer. Medic Jimmer has his own pop-up trailer. And then TechMan 2015, he's got a driving RV, and then he has a camper that fits in the back of his truck. So what I've decided to do is, because all of them are going to be visiting me, and Herbster, I think there's some numbers that follow his name or something, but Herbster also says, he has a big RV too, and he wants to come down and visit. So I'm making a visitor's RV parking spot, and that's what I'm standing in right now. And it's pretty much clear. I got a couple stumps here that are in the way, which will be pulled out. My dog is currently wrapped up around them. But that tree there, this tree here, and these three stumps right here are coming out. And the tree that my dog's tied to is coming out. But right here, if you look, I don't have to take anything out. These trees here that I just mentioned that were coming out, they're coming out because they're in the way of the driveway to bring the cabin in. But right here, it seems like there's a perfectly good square or rectangle set right here, where if I just clear out the brush and you could very easily pull an RV right in here, and it'd be perfect. I mean, it's very close to level. It's got a slight slope off right over there in the far right corner. But it's got a stump right there we'll have to remove. But it'd be very easy. You just pull right in the driveway, come in here, and pull right in here. And then when you want to back out, you just do the same thing. Or you can back right in, depending on where your door is and where you want it facing. So my visitors can come in right here. It also, when there isn't an RV here, gives more parking. We can pull in and park both the truck and the Jeep right where I'm standing, and that leaves the whole driveway open and free. And that'll be nice. So And that doesn't come anywhere close to touching my property, you know. So you see all these trees here, this is all mine and my wife's and my dog's, and I suppose it's my wife's cat's as well. So the five of us, this all belongs to us. So yep, it's nice. Alrighty, enough babbling, 15 and a half minutes of it, so we'll talk to you later. I'm going to get down there, finish chopping up that one big tree, and then I'm going to see if I can't help Addie take out those bushes there. So, okay, talk to you later.